is now streaming. Congratulations. Alright, so we are back for D&D session, Granite Keep number 14, which I'm changing right now. I am Godric, bard that is amazing, unlike some, you know, people are. Yeah. And everyone
Retosh. Retosh, half-orc, barbarian.
Car Dragonborn, who is about to step on Godric.
And not even have to even lift my leg.
Skeggy, I am a chaotic dwarf wizard.
And I'm Kelly, guy behind the scenes running the maps. We are down a man, if you've been watching us for a while. Steve is not going to be able to join us for a little while. He has some personal business that he has to attend to that's he's probably not going to be able to join us for a month, maybe slightly longer. So his character is going to take a short hiatus, and we'll figure out how and why during the story tonight. With that short explanation, back to what's going on. You guys recently took a keep, which belongs to Skeggy's uncle, who has disappeared and gone missing for a while. So the local mayor for the about the closest nearest town said, go out there, and if you can clean the keep, then you have a chance of keeping it. You'll have to come back and tell the Duke, who's a couple towns over. And if that works out, then you guys could possibly keep the keep. So you came here and you found that it was inhabited by a bunch of hobgoblins. You started evicting them and you found out that there were two other people here. One was a hobgoblin who kind of made friends with you. He surrendered, even though the wizard tried to burn him. And Mia, who appears to be...
He says that like so smooth and matter of fact.
Yeah, he tried to kill him by burning him alive, you know.
And Mia, who said she was left by his uncle as keeper of the keep, whose job is to protect the keep and maybe babysit Skaggy, we aren't quite sure. But I think she thinks that the keep is probably more important than Skaggy is. So at least that's what you've got your opinion so far. So... with that, they evicted the people. They closed the doors. They got a few injuries during the time, but they've been trying to rest over the night. They've left, I believe, Carr is on guard along with Mia for the first part. They all got some nice equipment upgrades from stuff that Uncle had left for each of one of them, kind of specifically for each one. Though Skaggy seems to have given his away to Godric. And can't get it back.
isn't Tamaris with us as well?
Oh, yes. Right at the end, a ranger friend of theirs named Tamaris had shot a couple of the hobgoblins and scaled the back wall of the keep and joined them. And he told them that Hamlet had been attacked. Though, through Tamaris and one of his friends, the bards, and Rufus, the local fighter and mage, they had driven them off, which basically means they had returned here. So outside this keep, there's about 75 hobgoblins, goblins, some warg riders, some archers, a few trolls, kind of outside the keep right now. And you guys are kind of trying to figure out what you're going to do. In the meantime, you were laying down to rest, couple of the people on guard, and Godric is having a bit of a time with it because whenever he was about to fall asleep, it sounded like somebody yelled boo at him. And I think that's about where we're at, heading to the first shift of sleep. Does that sound about right, guys?
Yeah, I believe so. Yep. And just to clarify, when I took the ring off, I put you know, the boo ring, let's call it that temporarily, Skaggy's ring, well, formerly Skaggy's ring, into my pouch where my night vision ring was, and I put my night vision ring on. So, still wearing a ring as it looks to Skaggy.
Okay. So, Retosh, Godric, Skaggy, and Halinor are getting asleep right now.
Can we roll a d6 hit die?
For?
To recover hit points?
Let's see. I think you had done that last time.
Okay, then I probably didn't update things on my end then.
Yeah, we did that, I believe.
I have you missing just a very few hit points.
Yeah, I have more than that, so I must have recovered and not updated.
Okay. Should I tell you and just tell
yeah,
you?
Yeah, if it's really low, it shouldn't make a big difference to everyone.
I have you with a wound of 3.
Yep, okay. I didn't update. Thanks.
Godric? You're about double that?
I am full from my standings.
Okay, I had you down 7.
Did I get injured in the last battle?
And Retosh was down. He's just got a scrape.
Yeah, I didn't get injured in the last battle, and I remember when we ate, we refilled. Remember? We rolled hit dice when we had a short rest, and I sang a song of rest. Rolled hit
dice. Did you get hit? I thought something. I can't remember, but I have you down 7.
I mean,
I don't remember him getting hit. Yeah. He was doing the oil. He didn't really get involved in any.
Okay. Well, we can...
I know I was hit. I think I lost 1 hit point.
You got it back, though, with rest, didn't you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I have you full.
Yeah, when we went and had the snack.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
Sorry to meta, but that's where we're at, I think.
No, that's fine.
You're angry about it, Odin. Just admit it. It's okay.
Oh, no. How dare you tell my hit points to Retosh? He's going to write that shit down.
Is this a betting, Odin?
7 hit points?
What spells do you have again? Can you tell me?
What spells do I have? Yeah. Those two. That's all I have. The only 2 spells I have.
Hey, it's more than I have, dude. You're doing good. Oh, wait, that's right.
I don't even remember what level 3 spells I chose. That was so long ago. I wrote them down somewhere.
So you guys did manage to kill about 6 of the hobgoblins and a troll last time. They don't appear to have attacked through the night. You guys switch shifts about halfway through the night. And the 4 of you are... 3 of you are up, and Carr is sleeping, and so is Mia.
Is Tamara staying up through the night, or is he...
I think he went back to sleep as well.
Okay.
And so now the sun's coming up, and they're coming out, and you guys have woken up, and I believe everybody is full on hit dice again. You'd still be short this unless you want to roll 1, Godric.
Well, am I down 7? Are we saying I'm down 7?
Yeah, let's see. Let's keep that.
Okay. In that case, when we went to sleep, I would have sung my song of rest or whatever. So yeah, I'll use a hit dice just to get back up, which means okay. I'm down 1, right?
1 hit dice.
Okay. Which is, it's a d6 plus the Song of Rest is another d4?
D6, I believe, for the Song of Rest, and you are, and what's your, oh boy.
Is it a d8? My hit dice is a d8? Maybe? Or are they 2 d6s?
Godric is a d8.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Alright, so...
So a D8 and a D6.
Oh, yeah. Boom. Oh. There you go. Hey. Gotta get the ones out somewhere, okay?
So you're full.
I'm better on the 6 than the 8.
Yeah, dude. Much better.
Okay.
Okay. And we have hit dice equal to our level, right?
Yeah.
Well, I guess we would have recovered after sleeping, so I'm back to full.
Okay.
I think, are we all back up to full at this point?
Is it before or after the rest? How's that work? Is it after you wake up?
After a long rest, then you can recover your hit dice. Okay, during the rest, you regain them. So I'll give them to you now. Either way, it usually it's after, at the end of the rest, you'll get them back.
I mean,
in case you get attacked during the rest. But,
right. But I mean, when do you use them? You use them after the rest or before the rest?
The hit dice?
Yeah.
Before.
Okay.
Well, you can do it either.
I would assume
but
it
if
would
you
be
didn't have them before the rest, then up. You won't have them to use during the rest.
Right.
Is the way I would play it.
Okay.
All right. So, based on that, you guys are waking up. And looking out across, and there's not a lot of activity because most of those guys don't like to be out in the sunlight. But it looks like some more have joined them. So you've got a pretty good-sized band out there.
Yes.
Any idea what you want to do?
Well, if there's a band, then I'm going to sit back and listen to the music. No, I don't know.
Yeah. Poor choice of words. Sorry.
So like are I just Kelly, up here. Kelly, are they hiding in the trees?
Yeah. Maybe not hiding. They aren't. You could see that they're in the trees. They aren't being inconspicuous, like sneaking, but they don't like light. Hobgoblins and goblins tend not to like bright light. So the shade's a little bit nice for them. Plus, they're out of arrow range.
So is it just the ones we fought yesterday, or is it that the other ones joined up with them?
It looks like they've joined up with them.
Both of the other two?
Yeah.
Hmm. So we're looking at like 20-something ish?
More like triple that.
Wow.
60 people.
Wow.
Whew.
Okay. So.
You know, I wonder if we should, you know, create a diversion or something, and then maybe I could go, like, run out behind them and try Burning Hands since they're in the
burning
trees.
Burning Hands, 60 people, yeah. You go do
burning
that,
hands.
Yeah,
okay.
Unless you have dragon breath coming from your hands, I don't think Burning Hands
where's the
means
too much.
It is only a 15-foot cone, unfortunately, but if we could get some of that oil going.
I don't think everyone's standing shoulder to shoulder above 60 people.
No, they're kind of surrounding the keep.
Yeah.
I vote no on that.
Yeah.
So I just woke up, right?
Yeah.
All right, well, I'm going to go to the kitchen. I'm going to go have some breakfast. Hey, can't fight on an empty stomach, man. You got to have the energy. And, you know, carrying Godric around, you got to have even more.
So Mia's taking a look out the window, and as you're starting down the stairs, all of a sudden she starts running behind you. Out of the way! Out of the way! We got to open the doors! Open the doors now! And she's running toward the main gate. Open the postern! You, come with me! Help! She kind of gives you a tug as she goes by you, Car.
I bet she does give me a tug.
Jesus. Oh.
Yeah. So, since I haven't ever seen her this excited, I'm definitely following her.
The rest of you guys are kind of up in the, you guys are meeting up here, which is where you normally do, so that you can watch out the windows and stuff.
So, why does she want to open the gates, or is she, like, already, like, booking?
She's already booking towards the gates.
I'm going to run after her and ask her what the fuck's going on. Meanwhile, I when I wake up, I switch out the rings again. You know, I switch back to,
okay,
to the other rings.
Godric, the three of you up here see Grinkle kind of looking out the portal and He's kind of shaking his head, kind of looks amazed.
You said portal?
Looking out one of the windows.
Porthole, not portal.
Yeah, sorry.
Big difference. I was like, oh, shit, there's a portal in the castle. Fucking run.
And this is where we go from D&D to Shadowrun.
Portals, the video game. Woo!
Okay.
Yeah, as they ran up there, I'm not necessarily like running, but I'm just kind of like walking up into that area to figure out what's going on.
Yeah, I'm following too.
I'm definitely kay. Running because I don't want our bitch ass to open the gate.
So, those of you down at the gate see a cleverly hidden door inside the gate that she's opening. It's pretty nice dwarven work that hides it pretty well. Many of these big gates have a small door that an individual can go in and out, but this one is, it's almost like a secret door in the gate, the way that your uncle's made it. And she's opening that. And the rest of you outside see two ladies who are about halfway across the clearing walking towards you. And Grinkle looks at you and says, they walked out of a tree.
Who walked out of a tree?
Two ladies. Keep up. So these ladies walked out of a tree with all the hobgoblins and
aren't
nothing's following
breakfast?
Them?
Hold on. Aren't you eating breakfast?
No, I followed her. Oh. There's some archers that appear to be taking aim, and one of the ladies waves her arm, and a large gust of wind comes up and blows the arrows away as they're midair towards them. And they keep calmly walking to the entrance.
Lady of Death's friends.
I think I'm just kind of like shocked by the scene of what's going on, and I'm not really sure what to say right now.
Yeah. I mean, I asked her. I'm like, why? Who are these people, and what the hell's going on?
It's Lady Octavia and Savara.
Oh, of course.
And the two of them walk in, and she opens the gate for them and then closes it behind them. And there's one is an older lady with just a dominating presence. You can just feel power emanating from her. The other one is a very slim lady with her hair is almost white and her skin is very, very pale also. And neither one of them are really wearing armor of any kind. Mia and Savara, the lady with the silver, with the white hair, hug each other and they almost look like, I don't know, old college roommates having a blast or meeting. But Mia also had welcomed Lady Octavia and treated her with respect. Said, escort these into the main hall.
Get
Skaggy. He'll want to talk to them.
I was going to say, as she says that, I'm already reaching out my hand and, kind of gesturing that we're going to walk this way.
Okay, so you're coming down? Because you were up above.
Yeah.
Those who came in.
Oh, yeah, but I mean, when I saw all that crazy shit, I would have walked down, and then they would have walked in, and then I'd walk back up with them.
Okay.
Yep.
So who's all going into the hall, and who's staying up in the wall?
I'm making sure the door's closed.
Okay, so Godric's in there. Carr, where do you want to go?
I'm going to go to the hall.
Let's assume Retosh is just with Godric for now.
Okay. So you're sending Godric back up here?
We're not looking at the map. There we go.
Yeah, Retosh is with Godric, hanging out. Are you guys hanging out in that keep, or like that guard tower, or by the gate?
No, that's the tower that essentially opens and closes the gate.
Okay, yep, so you're hanging in there. Okay. Yes.
I'm just Tanner's is out here a bit, and you have Retosh and Godric. And she is sent for Helenor. And Lady Octavia says, I need to speak with Helenor. I have business that he must attend to.
He's still sleeping, so.
I say he had a couple unlucky trips on his way up here, but here he is.
Okay. So you get him, and those two go off and talk, and Mia says, you kind of get a little bit of a scoop from her that Lady Octavia is one of the Archdruids. She is very high in Helenor's circle. So, Sivar says that she has come to send him away on a mission. He's got to do some stuff for her.
What missions?
Said he's being sent to find the Band of Bronze.
Better not be killing anything, because you picked the wrong guy.
Yeah, I mean, I think about it for a minute.
Hey,
sad to see him go. But then I'm like, well, he does roll a lot of ones. Well, okay, good luck to you, Halimar.
You know, hey, remember, he has gotten kills. He just tries to kill us, too.
Yeah. He can thorn whip the shit out of somebody.
Well, yeah, so he's going to be fine.
Well, Car, by himself. Car, in your eyes, he's like 2 kills for 10 attempts. In our eyes, he's like 2 kills for 100 attempts.
Hey, remember,
we've been with him a little longer.
You know, he's almost burnt my dick off with acid, so.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
So meanwhile, the other thing is, though, he's your healer. And you got a whole bunch of bad guys outside. So after she's had her talk with him, she comes back and says, I'm sending Helenor on a mission for the Circle. I'm afraid he must leave. There's urgent. He must try and find the Band of Bronze and notify them.
Yeah, I mean, as they're leaving, you know, I kind of speak out loud to the group, like, that's our healer.
I mean, and me and Retosh are gone, so we don't know really what's going on.
No, you guys don't know. I say, actually, at that point, I tell Carr, hey, Carr, why don't you go grab those guys? Because they need to know about this.
All right, so I'm going to... Okay. I'll just go out there. Okay.
Yeah, because we still have the other guy, like, watching the wall, so...
Okay. So you come back, and Helenor's getting ready to say his goodbyes. He's sorry to leave you at a time of need.
Where's Helenor going?
He has to go and travel around and find some of the original members of the Band of Bronze. And they are an adventuring group that took out a temple that is near here about 30 years ago. And they were named the Band of Bronze for a simple bronze ring that they all wore. They were given as a token of their appreciation for one of the early adventures that they had. And it just kind of stuck with them. There is a half-elven archer named Strongbow that used to shoot the crap out of arrows. There was a knight named Edaf and a cleric named Duncan. And a halfling warrior, according to him, though he was of the kinder persuasion, so everybody else thought of him as a thief, named Quinnaby. And there was also a lady named Silvara, if you remember your lore correctly, which Skaggy does. And you also notice that this Silvara next to you is wearing a simple little brand ring of bronze. But there's no way that she can look to be 30 years old.
What are you sanding, Howard?
I'm not saying anything.
Sanding.
Sounds like you're sanding.
Oh. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I was asking what you're doing with some wood there.
Yeah, he's trying to upset the druids.
Oh, it's cleaning off laptop. I didn't think you guys would hear it.
Yeah, it sounded like you were sanding your fucking table.
I think you just found out where your mic is at.
No, it's supposed to be on my headphones, so it's weird.
So, what do you guys want to do? Or you got any questions? Or
I mean,
could you, ladies, help us with our small problem outside?
Before Halinor leaves, before you take him away from us, one last thing. I think Halinor should make us some berries, because he can make those healing berries.
They only last 24 hours, though, right? I mean, yeah, that would be nice.
That's still a pretty long time,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, if we make it 24 hours.
Exactly.
Your problem? And Lady Octavia looks generally somewhat puzzled.
What? All the hobgoblins outside.
I'm afraid I don't involve myself in such affairs. I try and stay neutral on such things. But Silvara, you may help them if you wish. And Octavia starts walking outside with Halinor following her.
Did we get the berries from Halinor before he left?
I don't know. He's in chat. Did we, Halinor?
Damn it, I want those berries.
Yes, he'll cast them quickly and give you the berries.
Alright.
And
Skaggy has
Mia turns to Silvara and says, "Are you gonna eat a couple of them?" She goes, "Oh no, they give me indigestion. They're greasy." Yuck. She goes, "Oh, this should be fun." And Mia looks quite excited and happy as she starts walking out with Silvara. She turns and looks at you guys. You guys want to watch?
Yeah, I'm going to go to that, like, you know, area where I can kind of see by the gate. Yeah, I'm definitely watching this shit.
You all heading up there?
Sure.
Yeah, I watched something.
I want to go out with her. I don't want to just sit inside. I want firsthand what's going on.
Okay, so Carr's going to see if he can squeeze through the gate.
Yes. He's going to try to like crawl through the little dwarf hole.
Hey, just because I'm a big dragon, dude, doesn't mean I'm not flexible. Gosh. I got pretty good agility. Come on.
I think he should make a roll for that, right, Kelly? Does he get through?
Does he break the door?
Yeah, he's still flood all the hobgoblins.
You hear a
bunch
of barking and carrying on as you guys open the door, and streaking from the woods come two large wolves, one of them black with purple spots, or bluish spots, which is Rain.
Yeah, I was going to say, we know him.
Yeah,
and the other one with him is a more of a brownish typical wolf who seems to look at Howard with a runs inside and starts. They both start wagging and running. One Rain runs up to Tanneris and the other one runs by Howard and starts kind of coming up to everybody else.
kind of run up to it and I kind of pet it. That's the one from before, right?
It bites your hand off.
Kind of looks at you, kind of giving you the cold shoulder for leaving her outside. Abandoning your pet.
Yeah. I was wondering what happened to her.
She said, bitch. I
forgot about it.
Oh, man. Cruel.
Yeah. Fucking animal cruel.
Write that down.
Retosh, no animals allowed.
The lady looks over at you, and she does seem strangely familiar. Though you know you've never seen her before, there's something that seems very familiar about Lady Octavia to you, Retosh. You aren't quite sure what it is, but she does look at you and say, you really should take better care of your totem. And Savara steps out, and several of the hobgoblins look like they're making toward her, and all of a sudden she kind of becomes blurry and starts stretching and changing form and growing, and the sun starts reflecting off her very bright silver skin as she becomes a silver dragon.
Oh,
no big deal.
And she launches herself into the air, and the hobgoblins head for the trees again. And she does about two circles of your keep and lays off into one area with a nice breath of cold air.
See, they're scared of fire. I told you I should have used burning hands.
Oh, no, it's not fire.
I'm just kidding.
Ice breath. Jesus. I'm sorry. They might not be scared of ice breath, but I guarantee you when they're frozen, the bitches are going to run.
It's cold. It's cold.
Well, the ones that are not frozen.
Oh, this is an ice-breathing dragon. Shit.
Mia turns and kind of punches Retosh in the shoulder. Now that's cool. And that sends most of your hobgoblins fleeing.
Yeah, I would say so.
That's what I'm talking about.
Did I make it through the door? Just asking. Did I make it through the door?
Yeah.
Okay.
He actually saw none of it. He saw absolutely nothing.
I'm stuck in the door. My head. Hey guys, let me in! get the butter!
So she lands and shifts back to her human form and smiles to you and says to Kara and says, yes, little cousin.
Oh.
Let's go back in.
That's pretty sick, Carr. That's messed sick. Up, man.
Hey, I can't argue with it. Did you just see that cool shit that just happened?
Like, he was talking about getting tugged by his... He was talking about getting tugged by his cousin.
No, that was Maya. Hey, whatever. Hey, whatever floats the dragon, dude. Whatever floats the dragon. He's gonna hate.
You see a little, as you enter in from the far side of the keep, you see some more shape-shifting. You see Halinor turn into a large eagle and fly off.
Whoa.
When did Halinor become badass? Hold on, what happened?
No, I know, right?
He must have just rolled like his first... His
right
first
there.
Yeah, he rolled his first 20 ever. Like, he was like, I'm out, bitches!
And the whole time we're just sitting here like, where was this eagle the whole adventure?
I give him the head nod as he flies away, like, you know. He knows what's going on.
Doing your fucking head nods.
Godric's a man of little words. He just actually, that's bullshit. He likes to talk all the time, but yeah. He likes the subtle nuances of conversation. He's very charismatic, if you didn't know.
I like the head nod. All I'm thinking is Night of the Roxbury.
He's like this to the eagle. Right? He's like, boom.
Lady Octavia signals to Silvara that it's time to go. Please say your goodbyes. We must move on. And she walks. She heads for the little door and heads out of the keep and starts walking across the clearing. Mia and Silvara seem to be saying goodbyes, and then Silvara runs to catch up, and the two of them appear to walk into a tree and disappear.
A dragon that walks into a tree, okay.
Did y'all just see that shit?
I'm kind of
bitches
like,
be crazy!
Bitches be crazy! So I look over at me and I'm like, so that just happened.
Wait, so did Mia leave with them or is she still with
them? No, Mia's still here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so...
She does turn to Ritosh, Mia, since you two are still standing somewhat close together. She goes, by the way, never try and outdrink Silvara. Bad things happen. I think it's time for breakfast.
Me too, I agree. Let's get something to eat.
Freaking Carl already ate breakfast. Fucking
I didn't get to eat.
Gluttonous bastard.
I'm starving.
Second breakfast.
Second breakfast.
You know, I'm on the 10th breakfast by now, all right? Leave me alone.
Grinkle's still looking out the window. Does that mean they're all gone?
For now.
Yeah, if not all of them, just about all of them. Whatever is left, we should be able to handle on our own, Grinkle.
So
are there any left, Kelly? Do we see any of the stragglers that thought they could take us on, or they all pretty much saw the dragon and ran?
You don't see anybody from scouting the Tower Keep. Tanaris comes and joins you and goes, I haven't seen anybody out there either. We can follow or we can make a plan. So Mia's heading for breakfast.
Yeah.
Carl, I think, is with.
Yeah, I think I'm going to get some food.
Yeah, I think we all do.
We need to go have a conversation about what just happened.
Right.
Because that was a silver dragon that just tore some shit up.
So, sitting around the table, having a nice, healthy breakfast. Eggs and meat and bread, some cheese.
And beer.
You have Ritosh and Carr and Godric and Skaggy. You also have Grinkle, Mia, and Tanris. And
what about my wolf?
Two wolves.
Okay, cool.
So we're sitting at the table, and I'm gonna kind of look at everybody, and you know, kind of go, "Fucking eagle, where the fuck was that at?" He turned into a wolf one time, but like then he fell into some clay pots, and he was naked, and really didn't do anything. Like,
I think he was trying to turn into an eagle the entire time he's been with us, but he was just never successful.
Ah, that's what happened. Okay.
I'm looking at everybody else. I was like, yeah, does anybody know about this whole eagle business? I've never seen that before.
Hey, you guys have been with him way longer than I have. I don't know shit.
Okay, besides the eagle thing, I'm going to talk to Tamaris and be like, you know, you mentioned that some people were on the way. Gordrig and some of the others. Are they still coming? Did we send word to that, or...
He said they were going to send whoever they could after. He thought it might only be Gordrick the Bard. The Rufus and the others were saying we're probably going to... I think their plan was to tend to the wounded and stay at Hamlet. They couldn't, in case they circled around, they can't leave Hamlet undefended.
Right.
And when you showed up, you said we had to choose, like, either fight them or go back to town, or I thought there was a third option.
Well, now it seems like you guys can decide what you want to do. I mean, you can follow the Horde and maybe, you know, left to their own devices, there's enough to come back and bother you here at some other time. You don't have enough manpower to really ward them off.
So I thought that the castle had, like, there was like a time limit, and we had to get back to the guy who originally talked to us about the keep in the first place to claim ownership of it, right?
Yep.
So we need.
So that's another thing you need to do. You need to head all the way back to Arendelle to. Right. And it's not at Hamlet. It's all the way. It's further to a town you haven't been to yet.
So I'm just going to throw out the simplest option, everyone. You know, I say we make our way back to Arendelle, and maybe if we double time it a little bit, we can catch up to a couple of the hobgoblins and trolls and pick a few of them off. All right.
How did they? What was the condition? How did they know that we did anything? We could have just been picking our asses outside camp the whole day, and then just show up and say we took the thing over, right? What are we? How do we prove it? What do we need to prove it?
Huh? Maybe if he had some sort of ring or something. I don't know.
Sort of.
You know that sort that of ring. The ring.
Maybe he has some insignia on it or something. I don't remember.
So, Godric, do you have a new castle?
My plan is going perfectly.
He gave it to you. We all saw.
He put it on my hand like he was fucking proposing marriage, dude.
Tell me if this is real conversation or meta. I need to know before I speak up.
This is a meta conversation.
All right. Good.
No, so, yeah, I mean, gonna ask, you know, Mia, like, you know, how could we prove that this is the keep, we are in control of the keep now? Why would we need to prove it to this fucking random guy? Like, who is this guy?
No, the guy told us, remember? He said, go clean it up. If you clean it up, I'll allow you to take ownership of it.
I mean, we have the mayor. The castle's ours.
Still, who is he?
The mayor of Hamlet is the one who talked to you about that, and he's not the one who's going to be able to give it to you. It's the duke of the area who actually can give land grants and entitle people. What he's doing is your uncle has a land grant from him from the past. So if the duke sees you as worthy, he can pass the title to you. If he doesn't see you as worthy, the Duke has another little keep demand somewhere out there, and he can send his half-retarded nephew that he doesn't like to take it over if he wants, you know?
Right.
They can do whatever they want.
So, Mio, you said that Skaggy's uncle isn't dead. Is there some way we can bring him back?
No, he's out of communication for now. There is one way he said that he would possibly be able to communicate with him, maybe.
What's that?
I have no idea. He just hinted at it. And he was bad with hints.
Because of my intelligence, I'm assuming that my character is catching on to what's going on over here. I immediately look at Godric without skipping a beat. I grab his hand and I take that ring off of his hand.
Now, hold on. Now, as Godric has a high dexterity, he would immediately.
So I don't know if you made it or not. I think there's only one way to tell if you actually got your hand away in time.
Well, yeah, I think you need to make a dex check too, sir. I think we need to do a little roll up.
Dex off. Dex off.
Dex off.
Dex off. All right, go ahead. Do your reach. Do your little D20 reach. Come on, let's see it. Oh, yeah. Fuck you.
God damn it.
So I pull my hand away. Like, I'm eating breakfast. Wait a
minute. Godric, you need to roll a... I need to roll another saving throw for you.
You need me to roll another 20? Car. With Car. All right, I'll roll another 20.
I'm starting to steal your beer.
That's right.
A 12.
I didn't want to have to go to the kitchen.
Okay.
I don't know what a 12 does or if I'm modifying it, but I have a 12.
You feel a bit of a tension through your mind, and it kind of grates at you, but you notice Skaggy moving toward you quickly and jerk your hand out of the way at the last second.
So I became Spider-Man when I fell asleep, guys. Fucking, just letting you know. Fucking my Spidey sense went off, and I went, bitch! Like, and I'm like, "What? Hold on, why are you trying to take my ring? I got this from the pouch, what are you doing?
I was like, no, that's the ring that I passed over to you to see if you were feeling the same effects of it that I were.
No,
I didn't
see.
I didn't give you that ring. I didn't give you that ring. I was letting you borrow it to try it out. You took it and kept it from me.
No, and I'm saying this.
I am saying this so everybody around this fucking table can hear me calling your ass out.
Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to trick Skaggy. And saying that, see, what I did was, I did hear some voices, but I kind of bring Skaggy in. I was like, and I put my hand kind of under my armpit. I'm like, I did hear some voices, so I took it off at night and I put it in the pouch. So, you know, let me get it. So I pull out the ring from the pouch, which is actually the night vision ring, and I give it to him. I'm like, I'm sorry. Here's your ring.
No, but wait, you told us. So I take his pouch. And now I'm going to meta because you actually told us that you were putting the night vision ring on. You changed your mind. So you just gave me my ring back.
No, in the morning, I switched the rings back. Yes, I did.
Yeah.
But when you put the ring on, you're going to know it's the wrong one because you're going to have night vision.
Right.
No, he already has night vision. So
well, I already have night vision, so it would have no effect on me, but I do put this ring on.
Well, I will give you a check, and you know it's not the right ring.
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. You don't even have to make him roll for that.
I mean, I rolled for it.
Fucking hell.
Because otherwise I would let him get away with it.
Deception plus six. Come on, Kelly.
I put this ring on.
You need a plus eight.
I'm putting this ring on and I'm just like, And I'm just kind of like, Something's not right here.
What's wrong? I'm totally playing the shit off like I gave him the right ring.
Like I think you just pulled a little switch on me. I tell you what, let's just trade rings really quick.
Why? This is my night vision ring.
Let's trade rings.
That's what I got in the pouch.
We'll see if I have the same effect, and if I don't, I'll give you this ring back.
But see, I just gave you the ring. I mean, just like you gave me the ring before. I mean,
yeah, I'm thinking you're trying to pull a fast one on me here, Godric.
I mean, why would I do that? I know you let me borrow it, and I'll give you the ring back, which I did.
I can tell it's not the same.
Eventually, after we argue
I put my hand up into the air, and I try talking to the ring now. Like, but I'm kind of doing a little, you know, I'm kind of like talking to my hand a little bit.
So after we're arguing for a little bit, I kind of give in and I'm like, all right, you know, and I make him give me the ring back in the pouch before I hand him the actual ring. Do you comply, Skaggy?
I comply.
Okay, so he puts the ring back in the pouch. I get the pouch back in my possession. And then I reluctantly take the ring off. And like, there you go. And I was like, I really, you know, and I played off. I'm like, I have these fucking two gold rings. I can't keep track of this shit. I really thought I gave it the right one.
No one believes you.
Hold on. I have deception, dude. Let me roll for that shit at least. Come on. Doing it anyway, Kelly. We're DMing our own shit. Bam. I do not convince anybody.
In fact, he just paid us all 5 gold.
No.
We all just drink our beer and we're like,
just shake your head.
So yeah.
You hear so, Skaggy?
I come up with a bullshit lie and I give him back the ring and there you go.
Skaggy, you hear a little whispering in your ear. Well, that was very interesting. Hey, I really think he should try some of your uncle's armor. Downstairs, there's a little room, and inside, since he gave me back, I would give him that armor. It's even made for a halfling, I think. It should fit him.
So I'm just kind of like trying to play off like I don't hear anything at all. And I'm just like, hey, guys, I'll be right back.
Where are you going?
I got to just, you know, take care of something. Got to, you know. All right. You're going to make me say it. I'm going to go take a poop. There. Are you happy, Ritosh? I'm going to take a poop. Is that what you wanted me to say?
No.
No, it's not what I wanted actually. No.
I'm gonna kind of walk away.
Roll for constipation or not.
How much cheese did you have is the question.
So I'm gonna kind of like talk to the ring, you know, like once I get further away, I'm just kind of like, all right, where am I going?
So it leads you downstairs into near where you had where you got your item before, and there's a little door, and it leads into another area, and inside there there's two partial sets of leather armor and one complete set of leather armor, about halfling size. The other two seem bigger, but this one seems halfling size, and it's all black leather armor.
I say, all right, so I grab this stuff, and then I kind of walk up the stairs a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, hey, Godric, come here, buddy.
I'm assuming, like, you're in earshot. I'm assuming I hear this. I'm like, you're taking a shit, dude. I don't want to go over there. Fucking nasty ass. If you need toilet paper, I'll go get you some leaves or some shit. Like,
I say, no, man. I took care of that already. It's all good. Come here.
Oh, you took like a woman poop all quick and shit. Okay, what's up?
I'm small, man. I don't take big poops, all right?
Hey, I mean, you're a dwarf. I figured you got a little bit of extra, you know, something.
I was like, hey, the ring and I, we feel bad about what happened at the table. So, down there, there's some armor for you. It's all yours if you want it.
Seriously? He just scared the shit out of me. He's giving you armor and shit. It's pretty awesome. Well, all right, cool. I appreciate it. And I go and I collect the armor. And I look at it, and I'm assuming this is better than what I'm wearing.
Yeah. It looks pretty nice.
So, I guess for game reasons, what does this do for me? I'm gonna, you know, start putting it on because it looks sexy black, and I feel like a dominatrix wearing leather armor. So,
you didn't give him a whip, too, did you, Kelly?
Yeah, give him a bull whip, perhaps.
No.
Oh, damn. Okay.
In a ball gag for Carr.
Yeah, so for game stuff, what am I looking at here, Kelly?
We'll find out the next time you get in a fight.
Oh, okay.
Burn.
I go.
So I go over and I slap Skag. No.
You notice he didn't come slap Carr.
No, no, I mean, he was the closest one to me. I slap the dick off Carr, whatever.
Leave me the hell alone. As he's checking out his armor, I'm walking back to the table so I can finish my beer.
So, you guys are got to figure out what you're going to do now. If you want to follow the horde, if you want to head back to that town, or the other thing is you might want to try and find help someplace to help you hold the keep.
Well, that was going to be my question to Mia, was like, what's Mia going to do now?
Yeah, I mean, we can't just leave and
Mia's not going to hold the keep. She just lets people in. She's just like, hang out here as long as you don't mess anything up.
Anyone that tries to fuck with her, she kills. So, like, it's not.
That's kind of why I want to talk to her and figure out what the hell her, you know, play and all this is.
Well, what's that town that they were having all those injured people and stuff at? Like, that they didn't want to leave it undefended? Amador. Yeah. Can they bring their injured there to take care of them there? And then they also can keep an eye on the keep?
Hmm.
So there's. They would be a more fortified position, wouldn't it?
There's Hamlet to the west, and there's Nold to the east. Now, Nold. Hamlet held up on its own pretty well, because they have a druid there, and a cleric, and a fighter, and a wizard who are setting up some keep. Yep. That's where you came from. Nold to the east, Tamar says, is it's a bit different. It's not like Hamlet at all. Some of the people there are a little less savory, a little. It's a wilder town. So
I still want to get an answer from Mia though. What she's up to?
So she would stay with the keep. She can, if you. She's kind of your Castilia now, so she'll take orders from you to some degree.
So I look at her and I kind of point to Ritosh, like, are you going to answer his question?
Which was?
Is she just going to keep letting people into our keep?
Well, if you tell me no, I'll keep the doors closed.
So let's do it this way, Mia. Unless the people have written word from me that they're allowed into the keep, or one of my trusted friends here, don't let them in.
As he says that, I start fucking getting a pen and paper out and start scribbling.
Party at the keep.
Yeah, party at the keep, bitch. I'm going to start posting signs around town and all the trees.
Mia, do you know any magic? Like, what's your specialty?
Mia? No.
Yeah.
Magic is not her. She's trained in martial arts.
Martial arts, okay.
She's
a monk.
For meta, she's a monk.
Mia, do you have any kind of flares or anything like that in the castle?
Flares? No.
Do we have flares? I don't know.
Yeah, we shoot them from our gun.
I'm just trying to think of, like, if we... So, I'm thinking right. We go back to Hamlet. Hamlet? Go get Hamlet, and then go get those guys, tell them what Carr said, to basically bring everybody to the keep, so they have somewhere to stay, and then they can stay at the keep while we go and get the... go to Alderwood.
So, Tanner says he could stay here with Mia, and if Gorik joins them, that's the bard. They could try and keep the doors closed. They couldn't really do a prolonged siege, but they think Savara probably gave them a good run anyway for a while.
Yeah, I would say so.
If they regroup, though, you probably have some time before
they reorganize and come back at you. But
should still have access to the back door, so
they could escape if need be.
What's keeping?
Are you ordering Mia to a suicide watch on the keep?
No, not for her life. But she should try to find us if she feels her life is threatened.
So she has to abandon the keep because your timing's off. She will, but she'll do her best to safeguard the keep.
Right. But, you know, I also tell her, you know, hey, if you need to be a little bit devious and if you need to learn how to be devious, you can talk to our friend Godric here. But, like, if you got to be devious with some people, you know, and, like, let them in so they don't destroy things but make them think that it's their keep, you know, and then wipe them out in the middle of the night or contact us to have us come in and fight them off, that's fine, too, you know. I was like, be smart about your decisions. I just don't want you to start letting in a bunch of hobgoblins and stuff for no reason.
She could work with that.
I'm not liking this plan at all.
Well, we haven't decided anything yet, right?
I know. So the proposed plan right now, from what I'm understanding, is we're going to go get the other fighters that trained us.
So...
to no, get the other people from the destroyed town to come to the keep and watch over it.
That was a suggestion, wasn't it?
Mia and the others were saying that they should be able to hold it off by themselves, so we don't even need to go get them.
Right.
Yeah, but they could go ransack that village again, and are we worried about those people, or are we just kind of like, oh, well, you can handle 60 guys or 50 or however many they regroup with?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't be against going out to that town to make sure that they're not going to get, like, wiped out or something. But then we should make our way back towards that Archduke guy or whatever who can then...
So you have to go through Hamlet to get to there anyway.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Let's go through there. Let's go that way then. And we'll just see if there's anybody who wants to help defend the keep while we're gone, because we're trying to... I mean... Was he like a? Was your uncle like a nice?
Do we have a claim? Or do we have anything that claims us to this keep other than we killed some hobgoblins and other than
check
that,
out my ring.
I mean, come on, Howard.
Well, I got my name, but you make a good point. So maybe before we leave the keep, we should try to search for some paperwork or something, right?
Yeah, a signia or something that proves right that, you know, we're not just people. I mean, because then if we give these people the keep, then they're like, oh, it's our keep now. And then we have to fight the people that trained us if they want to be douchebags. Like, right. I mean, Gorgeous and I are buddies, but I mean, you know.
Is there like a flag flying over the keep or anything like that?
Skaggy hears a little voice in his head saying, there's a box in your uncle's bedroom. You can go in there and have a signet ring.
So, guys, I'm going to go into my uncle's bedroom and go grab something. I'll be right back.
You hear voices again, Skaggy?
Man, you have no idea.
I knew you were crazy.
Which is crazy. I didn't hear any voices when I was wearing a ring. It's just crazy.
You know, didn't you fail trying to convince us that earlier?
No, are you still trying to? I failed trying to convince you I fucked up switching the rings.
Exactly. Oh. Not about the voices.
Not about the voices. Thank you all very right much. Jeez.
Roll. No, just kidding.
Roll.
All right, so I grabbed this box, Kelly, and yeah. I'm gonna bring it back to where the group is.
Inside, there's a little signet ring.
What does that mean?
So
it's a family ring or something.
Yeah, they have a lot of times when they seal official papers, they'll put a piece of wax on it and they'll press the ring into it, and it leaves an impression in the wax, okay, so that it makes an official seal, and then they can tell if the wax has been broken, somebody's read it. Each family has their own unique ring that other people will know who sent it, who sealed it, at least.
Gotcha.
So when you come back with this, obviously because I'm from this time period, I know all of this. I would suggest that we send a courier out with a letter to the Archduke staking claim to the castle or something, so we still can protect this area. I mean, yes, we can travel, but we're leaving this abandoned. I would rather go hunt the goblins down while they're weak and recovering instead of having them come back at full force. And we could do that and send out a
They're not really weak, though. They're just scared. They were just scared. We didn't really hurt them. I mean, we killed a few of them, but the other ones were fine.
I mean...
Yeah, but you know what? Them being scared is going to mean they're going to make bad decisions.
I don't see chasing down 60 hobgoblins being.
On a horny horse, we totally could chase them down on a horny.
Yeah, dude, that's what I'm saying. We got a horse.
Yeah, I vote that we send. I got to really remember all these guys' names now.
Send a raid party.
Yeah.
My notebook.
Tanneris.
See.
I don't have a notebook down here. I was just thinking that. I was like, I need a notebook. Tanneris back.
Too bad you didn't have somebody who could turn into an eagle and carry a little ring there for you.
Yeah. Wouldn't that be fucking glorious? Piece of shit, Eleanor.
As we're sitting here thinking of logistics, we say, God damn, Halinor, got us again.
But, like, in reality, Halinor would have dropped the ring in a swamp or something while he was flying. I mean, it would have been lost to time, and we all would have been screwed. I mean, let's get real. I mean, that's what really would have happened. Yes, he was an eagle, but, I mean, fucking
hilarious. I'm actually kind of leaning towards Godric here. I mean, that was one of the original points that I made, was like, you know, why don't we go after some of these guys while they're escaping? I still like that plan.
Okay.
We could run into a fuck ton of them, but I mean, what are we going to do? We're going to go talk to the Archduke, and he's going to be like, congratulations, the keep's now yours. Like, okay. And then
we take care of it.
It's overrun by hobgoblins again. Like, I mean, how many times are we going to have to fucking take over this keep?
So who's going to run?
That's why I was saying we go get help and then have people, have them get away from the keep.
I mean,
keep people out.
We can do that. If we want to make the keep like a safe haven.
Tanneris says there's a legend of a general who fought hobgoblins. Who is buried north of here's a ways. Maybe there's something in his crypt that would help you fight the hobgoblins.
I'm game.
You did not hear this, Carr. Jesus.
How do I not hear it?
It's in Skaggy's head.
Tanner said this.
I thought Tanner just said it. I was like, wait, how did I miss this?
I thought it was in Skaggy's head. My bad.
Not Mobius. Mobius is the ring.
Hey, write that down in your notebook.
Mobius is right here, dude. I wrote that shit down.
Write that down.
Mobius is already in the fucking book.
That's good advice, Tamers. What direction is it?
To the north.
I
vote to go there.
How far away?
He's not sure. He hasn't, in his travels, he hasn't been by it, but he thinks it's probably a couple days.
So we have the option to go completely out of our way to stake claim to this keep, or we can go tell people this is a safe haven, get them in the keep, and then go find this weapon to fend off an upcoming battle, which I think is probably the best option. And then we can stake claim to this keep
after the fact. Like,
you hear some barking going on outside.
I'm going to run out and...
Not a whole lot, but a little bit.
It's the wolves, right?
Yeah.
Can you ride
the wolves?
Yeah, just like the horn.
I don't know how big
totally
they are.
On a
I don't know how big they
are. Maybe those two can.
Godric could, you know, come on.
I could ride a wolf. You could not ride a wolf, okay?
No, that's what I'm saying. It's like, what do you, like, somebody could go to town, or like the two of you guys could ride the wolves, go to the north. Tanners can go to town to pass our note on, because you now have the insignia ring, and then, because that would give her the mark saying, hey, we're here, we got it.
Yeah, except I have to go. I would have to go take the insignia ring, right? Because...
Couldn't you do a letter?
Write a letter.
I mean, maybe we have Mia go, then we go to Hamlet, get the people that are protecting that, to get the people in the abandoned village to come to the keep, to hold the keep, and then we travel north to get the weapon. So we're doing everything all at once.
Yep. Yeah, there's
because
no...
I
the
trust
people
Mia
have been abandoned. There's no abandoned village. There's nobody's abandoned their stuff in Hamlet. They just got attacked there, but they're recovering. They'll be fine.
Right, so the plan is I'm going to write a letter. We're going to send it with somebody. They're going to go to the Arch so that we can get the keep under my name. Then we go to Hamlet. We bring whoever wants to come back to the keep to feel safe, we bring them to the keep. Then we go north to get the goblin super weapon and come back to the keep again.
Perhaps goblin super weapon.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, that
but is that be. Is that our plan?
I'm thinking that sounds like a good one. I mean, who do we want to send with a sealed letter? I mean, the only person I would trust to send one would be someone that has a stake in the keep, which would be Mia. But Mia is one of the most badasses other than the dragon that we've seen. So
I'm going to tell you guys, I have really terrible handwriting. So if somebody wants to write this letter, I'm going to go sneak out the back entrance of the keep, go grab my horse, make sure my horse isn't dead.
Your pony. Okay.
My horse. And I'm going to bring my horse.
Your pony.
And carriage. And the makeshift carriage thing that we had back into the keep, and maybe like Kara, Ritosh, one of you guys should come with me just to make sure we don't run into a bandit of goblins while we do that.
I look over at Kara and say, he's just trying to compensate for us. Okay.
No worse than you are.
Hey, I don't have a pony or a horse, okay? I walk. Thank you.
Tanners had left the room when the dogs were barking.
Yeah,
and,
I'm
going to
go check, too.
He comes back in and says, look what I found stumbling around outside. And there's Gorik, the bard.
My buddy!
Snap.
Does he look all right? You said stumbling outside.
Yeah, he looks fine. He looks
drunk?
Like... No, he just... It's a ranger giving a bard a hard time.
Well, I immediately, you know, set him up some food and, you know, say...
So
know.
while this is happening, is Ritosh or Carr coming with me to get this horse?
I'll go out there with you.
All right, so Kelly, we're going to sneak out and go get the horse and ride it back in.
Unfortunately,
sure
there's no riding it back in.
It's really weak?
No, I'm afraid it's been
killed.
Supper.
What? Hobgoblins, dude! What?
Trolls like horse.
DM Yummy. Kills my fucking horse? Are you kidding me?
Yeah, the horse is dead.
Oh. Kelly, I'm not forgetting this. I'm not forgetting this, Kelly.
You left your horse outside. What do you expect?
God. Dang it.
There were 60 hobgoblins around looking at something, and they're like,
we didn't ride it anyways.
No, we don't want that. We've been talking about eating your liver.
Didn't we have supplies on it?
Man. I went to a D&D miniature building website and built a beautiful stag for my dwarf just to have him fucking eaten by trolls. Damn it.
Is there wagons still out there that might
you're,
have
you're
stuff?
More upset about the horse than you were about Halidor leaving this.
Oh, yeah, dude. No. I'm
the horse actually
crying.
Did something. I mean,
I am crying over this horse. Like, I'm just, and Kara's just trying to figure out what the fuck is going on. Like, and I'm just like, oh my gosh.
I'm afraid the wagon, it made good firewood.
Well, you guys ain't got shit. That's what that just said.
Yep.
So the DM kills my horse and like half of my fucking inventory.
So my question is there any hobgoblins around, or are they all split away from there too because of the dragon?
It seems pretty peaceful right now. It ended up being a somewhat tense walk out there, and now it's more of a sobbing, consoling walk back.
Just chilling.
Sucks, dude.
Sucks, dude.
You're talking to the guy that had his party slaughtered and left naked in a room.
No mercy, dude.
You lost a horse and some shit. Like, no. Don't care.
Then you got a full keep.
Yeah, I mean, you have a fucking castle.
Yeah,
you got a keep like,
out of, yeah. I mean,
he's kind of right.
Yeah, I mean, he's saying this, and I'm just like, yeah, I got a keep. And I also want to know how the conversation with Godric and his bard friend is going when your bard friend is like, dude, why do you look like a mannequin?
I pull a little gag out of my mouth and I'm like, so anyway.
What happened to your beard?
Oh, no, you're talking. Well, I have no hair anymore and I have all leather on. So, I'm looking super fucking creepy, dude. I'm looking super creepy.
It's nice tight-fitting leather, too.
Yeah, I mean,
it is really tight for
him. I've got some, you know. Oh, Jesus. So, how's Gordrick, and can you teach me anything of importance?
Please don't look at me with my hairlessness.
Could I perhaps talk to him long enough to learn anything from him? Without telling Retouch.
As far as levels go, unfortunately, no, you aren't high enough to train yet.
I'm not high enough to train.
Nope.
I should know my level 3 stuff.
Well, you do, I thought, right?
No, I don't know my level 3 stuff. No one, Skaggy doesn't know his level 3 stuff either.
Oh, did we not train for level 3?
We didn't train to level 3.
Oh, yeah, he could help you train there.
Yeah, I got more spells.
What'd you got? What'd you get?
You will find out. Never!
let me know which card, man. You know
yeah. Pick the one in the middle. Pick the one in the middle. Do you have the bard spells too, or are those yours?
No, these are mine. I'm
okay,
fucking with
you. Okay,
metal
four, metal two, Jesus.
So yeah, we could get you trained up to level 3. Halinor got his training.
Halinor got his training? Yeah, because he took me off as a fucking eagle. I hope he got his training.
Actually, Kar and Retosh, you could spend a little time training with Mia. And you didn't make your level 3 stuff either, Retosh? I thought we had.
Nope.
I thought we did. I thought I did for mine.
No, we were on our way. We hit level 3 when we found the abandoned village, and we're like, yeah, let's go to this keep with all these hobgoblins and not train to level 3.
Yes. Yep.
Okay.
No one trained to level 3.
Okay. I gotta see. Let's see. What do we get at level 3 for
the barbarian? He doesn't know his level 3 stuff either. That's why he's talking about more burning hands.
You can get your base stuff at least for.
I'm a burning man.
Actually, guys, I'm gonna have to jump off pretty quick here. So, do we want to end the session and do the? You guys can do the leveling stuff offline. Or I could just, like, go on mute if you want so it doesn't mess up the overlay.
Well, I mean, let's come up with our solid plan, like, who we're doing all that stuff, and we can deal with leveling next time.
So okay. Your plan for the next time is you guys are going to leave the keep and travel north. Or first you're going to go to Hamlet. Is that right?
Yep.
Pretty much all of you.
And who's going to send... Or who's going to courier for us?
Who are you going to ask?
I mean, that's your goal. I mean, the ranger obviously is going to go the fastest, but...
Right.
That's, do we trust him enough to again? Do
where are they
that?
Going?
What? Can you pull up the map?
Yeah, can you, where's can you put the map
where
on
are they,
the...
Where are we sending these people to?
Let's see if I can find the right map for you. Hang on one second.
They're going to go... So, Howard, we need to send somebody as courier with a letter that I wrote and use the insignia ring or whatever to
the
mark.
Duke?
Yeah, they need to go see that Duke guy who I think is, like, down south or whatever.
Oh, nice. I didn't know we were taking care of that, too.
This is the world as you guys see it. Okay?
Yep.
And zooming in... Can you see? It gets a little blurry. There's a Principality Ulik,
yep.
Which is that area right there. The river that runs north, that's a little bit to the west, and it branches, and the little finger comes up and meets the mountains and the trees.
Yep.
You're in that little area. Right, okay. Just south of the mountain. Yep, just about where your mouse
that's
is pointing
where the
right
keep
now.
Is?
Yep. And where they need to go is about 3 days travel to, or probably about 5 days travel to the south and west of where you guys are.
Okay.
So when you look at that map, to the east, that... area is called the Pomarge that sticks out in toward the ocean. Mm-hmm. The little Florida area. That is overrun by humanoids. So by that, gnolls and goblins and hobgoblins. It's pretty much a wild area up to the river, which is the border. Then up through the forest, up along Woolly Bay, is the Wild Coast. And that's more humans, but it's more of a wild... pirates and that kind of area.
Yep.
West of the river in the V between is Selene, and that is an elvish land. That's one of the areas that's primarily controlled by elves. The whole mountain range, all the way from the ocean up into there, all the duchies of Ulix, that is dwarven. Dwarves own or control a lot of that, are very, very influential in a lot of those areas. You also find in the Principality of Ulik and a lot of these areas, there are a lot of halflings and other, not so much elves west of it, but there's a lot of gnomes and halflings and dwarves.
So
these are... They and a lot of humans, but humans, when you get to the kingdom of Keoland, that becomes more a primary human-run area. Or if you zoom out, you can go up into the Grand March.
And where's the Hamlet land?
So Hamlet is just essentially a day away from you.
So it's
like south or something.
Yeah, it's right. It's not even to the river from where you guys are at.
Okay. Gotcha. And then the crypt is to the north of us, right?
So you guys are kind of on the last, far as north as the Principality of Uluk goes. That is in controlled area. When it gets much more north of you or east of you, you start going into lands that are much more wild. Now, quite a bit north of you, you'll come up into Elvish land, which is, but you almost have to get all the way up to the V in the rivers to get into the Elvish controlled. So there's kind of a wild area in between.
Okay.
And I believe the grid is 30 leagues. That gives you an idea of scale.
Oh, yeah, you can barely see it. The hexes?
Yeah. And I think that's about what you can make in a good day with a horse.
Which we no longer have.
Yeah, which a DM loves to kill because he's sadistic and likes killing animals.
Hey, your wolf survived.
This is true.
They were forgotten about, but they survived.
Fuck your hopes!
Fuck your hopes! Alright. So they have to go down. Where does the messenger have to go? Just so we know how far away that is.
It's going to be a good week's travel to the southwest. So maybe about where the letters start in the Principality of Uluk. I mean, when you would come from where you are to hit the first letter.
Okay.
Maybe the L in Principality.
Oh. So since Godric is pretty friendly with Gorik, right? My recommendation is that we send the ranger and have the ranger take the letter.
Give us some supplies.
Yeah, I mean.
Yep.
I think we would trust him enough. We saved his wolf brain. I mean, maybe. It's everyone's call. I trust Mia more because she has more invested in the keep. But again, the ranger will travel faster and blah, blah, blah.
Right. So let's do this. Why don't we pay him for the service? Like, and I'm just kind of talking to you guys. Like, I feel like we probably stepped away from the table of random other people. You know, how about we all pitch in some gold?
Hey, this is your keep. If this is our keep, then
we'll throw some gold.
If
it's our keep. Oh,
but, yeah. Oh man, are you real? I didn't even realize that was a question, man. This is our keep. Absolutely.
So
this
my name's going on it?
This is the party. This is the party shack, man. Absolutely. I only have one requirement of all of you. If you bring in any ladies, you got to bring in two. Make sure you bring in one for me, one for the owner.
I thought you just said it's ours.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'll bring in two.
You understand the concept?
Apparently not.
No.
No, I consider it all of our keeps. If you guys pick a room that's your room, I won't bother your room. So yeah.
Best bedroom.
You call what?
The biggest bedroom.
I call your uncle's bedroom.
Sons of bitches.
I need a big room with the big bed. Dude, I'm like 6'6", dude. You guys could all fit in the closet.
Whoa. We're bringing women in. We're not fitting in the closet, okay? I mean, Jesus.
Mia walks by and goes, "You aren't taking my room." And you aren't taking my dojo.
Mia, I have a feeling that that won't be a problem for any of us. So we explain. I'm gonna explain the plan to Mia. See what she thinks.
Okay. So, you're going to ask Tanneris if he would courier a letter and the ring, or just a letter to.
No, just a letter. But I'm gonna use the ring that
to seal it.
Yeah, to seal it. Yeah.
Okay.
And then, of course, I'm, you know, going to sign my name as fancy as I can.
And then you, as a group, are going to forge. Well, were you going to go to Hamlet as a group first? Or are you just going to send him off to Hamlet and then you guys go north?
No.
We can travel with him to Hamlet, I think.
Yep, I agree. Okay.
And then get the other guys come back.
We should probably ask Gorik and Mia to hang out at the keep until we get back, right?
So Hamlet's only a day away if you had a good horse. Without the horse, it's probably a day and a half.
You're just bringing it up. Salt in the fucking wound, dude. Fucking hell.
He never wrote it anyways.
I did too write it. I wrote it like 2 times in our adventures, but you guys didn't fucking care. Because none of you cared about my horse like I cared about it. God damn it.
What was its name?
His name was Fuck You. That's what his name was. So
I should ask Howard that too. What's the name of your wolf?
I was trying to figure that out.
It's not
okay.
He shunned him because he left his ass outside. He's lucky he didn't get eaten. So. They haven't bonded too much yet. He's still coming up with a name. He plays with his totem every day, by the way. He takes care of it. I saw him at least twice a day.
I gotta keep it clean.
You gotta keep it clean.
So I have a feeling. So I recommend that we have we go with the ranger to Hamlet, but everybody else stays at the keep till we get back from Hamlet.
I mean, the only person we can rely on to stay at the keep without paying them is Mia.
So how much are you?
Well, but you can ask Gorik, right?
I mean, I can ask him, but I mean. I can see what he says. You have free food while you're here and whatever, but that doesn't mean he will.
I think it's worthwhile, right? I mean, one more body.
Yeah, I almost think it might be useless to go to Hamlet to get everyone.
What if we just had the ranger just tell people that if they want to come to the keep. Or do we just not trust him enough?
No. I mean, we can't. Trust the ranger. Pay him, we can do that. I mean, if he delivers a letter, good. If not, we lost some gold, but...
Right.
We did save Rain, so it's kind of, you know, a favor he owes us. We didn't do shit for anyone else, is why I don't think really... I mean, well, you did tackle Gordrick, so I mean... You and him have a little bit of a weird standing.
This is true. Like, I'm trying not to make eye contact with him, actually, throughout all this.
His tip touched, and it was awkward.
so let's do this. We pay him what, like, I don't know what's reasonable for this. 20 gold now and 20 gold when he returns?
Yes, you pay him 20 gold now, and you pay him 20 gold later.
Yeah.
Okay. You offer that for him to courier a letter. He's willing to do that.
And to check on the town of Hamlet, and if anybody needs to come to the keep for safety, they can.
Okay. So it'd probably be about 4 days before you'd see anybody from that. So okay. He's more than willing to do that. Okay. And you ask, what are you going to ask of Godric?
Gorik,
I mean.
I just go up and talk to him. I'm like, hey, we're going out. We're trying to defend this keep. We're staking claim to it. You're more than welcome to stay here. if you help protect the castle, obviously, if it's being overrun, there's Mia can show you the escape hatch or whatever, but you're stay here for free, and there's food and drink here that you can have. Until we return, there might be people coming from Hamlet for safety that, you know, you might need to help and protect, and if you could do that, then, you know, you'd more than welcome to stay here, so.
Well, he and Tanner's kind of have a bit of a conversation, too, and originally he was thinking of traveling with him to the city, but he thinks that, seeing as how you guys are planning on leaving to go north, right, to try and see what else you can find that might help.
Right.
That he can stay with Mia, and though he kind of looks at her, he goes, kind of, assuming she gives the okay, because he's had her cold shoulder once, and he doesn't really.
I'm like, all you got to do is stay out of her way. She's a bad bitch. She just, you know. Just don't push any chairs around or tables. Don't light a couch on fire. I'll tell you about it later. And I think she'll be okay. Just kind of.
You might want to advise him Thunderwave is a bad idea.
Yeah. So we got into that earlier. I mean, you know, you saw me do it earlier. You know, it happened here in the dining room. And
as those guys are talking,
we're just kind of leaving it until we decide, you know, we want to actually make this home. I mean, if people come from Hamlet, they can move tables around and shit, but, you know, just don't touch any of the draper here.
As those two are kind of, like, talking back and forth, I'm going to go slide over to Mia and, you know, just kind of be like, hey, Mia, are you cool with this plan?
As he belches his beer in her face.
Shouldn't I have a charisma roll if that's really going to happen?
Go for your charisma roll.
Oh, jeez. Oh, gosh. Oh, all right.
Hey.
There you go.
Not bad.
And my charisma is plus one, so.
So. She goes, it sounds like a wonderful idea, my lord. She reaches over and gives your beard a little twirl with her finger, and she stands up and walks away.
Yeah, you got a little piece on the side.
What are you still sitting here for?
Maybe I got this leather armor from her. Shit, goddamn.
Yeah, so I can tell these guys are looking at me, and I just kind of reach down to the ring, and I'm like, what do you think about this plan?
Sounds like you've come up with a plan. I can help give you directions to the burial sites.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I was wondering about that. Oh, I didn't hear this, sorry.
I said excellent. I was like, all right, guys. I think we got a plan. Let's fill up on some beer and let's go do this.
So I think that's where we'll stop it for tonight, and we'll pick that up then next week. Yep. So
sounds like a plan.
If you guys want to stay on afterwards a little bit, we can get your characters leveled up.
Cool.
All right. Good.
Well, thank you for watching, everyone. We should be back next Thursday again, if around 8 o'clock, depending on retouch. But around 8 o'clock next week. And thank you for watching.